Hello students, welcome to the session of online teaching and learning of English language and literature. I am Manmohini Bhatia, English mistress at Government High School, Sherpur Kalan, Ludhiana. Today I am here to help you understand the topic tenses, simple present and simple past. But before we come to this topic, let me ask you a question. What is a tense? Yes, what is a tense? Do you know? I'm sure you know it very well. Take your time. Well, students, tense is the form of verb that shows the time or state of an action, and it is an important aspect of English grammar. Students, tense indicates the exact time when an activity occurred. It can be used to create different meanings from the same verb and help the listeners to understand the meaning behind your story. Now, there is another question for you. Do you know how many kinds of tenses are there? Yes, I'm sure you know this thing, that there are three main tenses in English: the present tense, the past tense, and the future tense. Students, the past is used to describe things that have already happened. For example, earlier in the day, or yesterday, or last week, or 3 years ago. The present tense is used to describe things that are happening right now or things that are continuous. The future tense describes the things that are yet to happen. For example, later, tomorrow, next week, next year, or 3 years from now. Look at the three sentences displayed on the screen. First is, Rahul speaks the truth. Next is, Rahul spoke the truth. And the third one is, Rahul will speak the truth. All the three sentences contain one single verb, but different tenses. Rahul speaks the truth indicates the present tense, which means that the action is presently happening. Rahul spoke the truth represents past tense, which means that the action has already taken place. And the last sentence, Rahul will speak the truth, represents future tense, which means that the action will happen in the coming time. Dear students, these three tenses, the present, past, and future, are divided into four kinds: indefinite or simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. But today we are going to discuss only the indefinite or simple aspect of present and past tense. Let's start with the first kind, that is simple present tense or present indefinite tense. Students, The simple present tense is a verb tense which is used to show repetition, habit, or universal truths. Let's discuss these uses one by one. So, the first use of simple present tense is to express repeated actions or repetition. The action can be a habit, a hobby, a daily event, or something that often happens. So when you say, I play tennis, or the teacher teaches in the class, or she always forgets her purse, that means you are referring to a hobby or a daily event or something that often happens. Here comes the next use of simple present tense on the screen. Students, we can use simple present tense to talk about things that are permanent, or you can say which are more or less always true. For example, we live in Ludhiana. Let's imagine that you live in Ludhiana, not for a short time, but for a long time, relatively long time, and it is rather a permanent situation. It is true for you most of the time. Or he works at a bank. When we say he works at a bank, that means it is his permanent regular job, not a temporary one. So, simple present tense or present indefinite tense is used to talk about permanent things also. Now, let's move on to the next use of simple present tense, and that is, it is used to express daily habits. Read these sentences. Radha goes for a walk daily. I go to sleep at 10 o'clock. My father reads newspaper daily. So all these sentences express the habits, daily habits of the subjects. If Radha goes for a walk, then she goes for a walk daily. It is her habit. When I say I go to sleep at 10 o'clock, that means it is my daily routine, my habit. And my father reads newspaper daily. So, simple present tense is used to express daily habits. Simple present tense or present indefinite tense is also used to express universal truths. That means the facts that were true before are true now and will be true in the future. For example, the sun rises in the east, or the earth revolves around the sun. So these are the facts that are true, always true. So simple present tense or present indefinite tense is used to express universal truths. Now, how to form the simple present tense? Well, students, simple present tense is simple to form. Just use the root form of the verb with es or s. That means first form of the verb plus s or es. If you look at the verbs used in the previous sentences, you will find that we have used root form of the verb with es or s. For example, teaches, works, reads, and rises. All these verbs have been taken from the sentences that we have read earlier. But here you have to keep in mind one thing, that we have used the root form of the verb plus es or s with only the third person singular subjects. I, we, you, they, and all the plural subjects take root form of the verb. For negative statements, we use do not plus first form of the verb for I, we, you, and plural subjects. For example, we do not learn our lessons, or you do not pray to God daily. So we have used do not plus root form of the verb with we and you here in the sentences. For singular subject, we use does not plus first form of the verb. For example, he does not tell lies, or Meena does not obey her teachers. So for the singular subjects like he, she, it, or any name, we use does not plus first form of the verb. Well, in case of questions, we use do or does before the subject and use the root form of the verb. For example, do we learn our lessons? So here, we is the subject and we have used do before the subject. And learn is the root form of the verb. Well, students, I hope you have learned simple present tense or present indefinite tense clearly. Now it's practice time, and I'm sure after this practice time, you would have a better understanding of simple present tense. So let's start with our exercise. Look at the screen. Here you have been given a few blanks and you have to complete these sentences by using simple present form of the verbs given in the brackets. Read these sentences carefully. The first blank here is the postman dash the letters, and the word in the bracket is bring. Number two, the children dash a lot of noise, and the word is make. Number three, you dash the guitar amazingly, and the word in the bracket is play. Number four, the train dash across the bridge, and the word is run. Next is, we dash near the airport, and the word in the bracket is live. Number six is, she dash her mother in the kitchen, and the word here is help. And the last blank on the screen is Ram dash home for lunch, and the word that is given in the bracket is go. So I'm giving you some time for this activity. Think about the answers and fill in the blanks with simple present form of the verbs that have been given in the brackets. So, take your time for doing this activity.
Thank you.
Well, students, I hope you are ready with your answers. So let's start discussing. The first blank was the postman dashed the letters and the word was bring. And the answer here is brings. The postman brings the letters. Well, I hope you remember that we use root form of the verb plus ES or S with the singular subjects. And the postman here is the singular subject. So we have used the word brings here. The postman brings the letters. Number two is the children dash a lot of noise. And the word is make. So we have used only the root form of the verb here because the subject here is plural, the children. The children make a lot of noise. Number three blank was you dash the guitar amazingly. And as you is there, so we have used only the root form of the verb play. So the answer is play. You play the guitar amazingly. Number four, the train runs across the bridge. Again, the train is singular subject. We have used S with the root form of the verb. So the train runs across the bridge. Now next blank was we dash near the airport and the answer is we live near the airport. Next is she dashed her mother in the kitchen and the answer is she helps her mother in the kitchen. We use root form of the verb plus ES or S with he, she, it and the singular subjects. And the last blank was Ram dash home for lunch. And the word is go. So we have used ES with it and Ram goes home for lunch. I hope students that you have understood simple present tense or present indefinite tense clearly now. Let's move on to our next tense. And that is simple past tense or past indefinite tense. Let's try to understand its uses. Students, simple past or past indefinite tense is used to express completed action in the past. Or in simple words, you can say that the simple past tense expresses actions that took place some time ago. Imagine someone asks you, "What did you do yesterday?" You will say that you watched a movie yesterday, or we watched a movie yesterday. She washed her car and Dinesh bought the camera from Delhi. So all these sentences express the incidents or the actions that happened in the past. And these actions are over now. They have finished. So, simple past tense or past indefinite tense is used to express completed action in the past. We use the past tense of the verb. That means the second form of the verb with all the subjects, singular as well as plural. Look at the sentences given here. He worked honestly. They took milk for breakfast. I bought this book last month. So with singular as well as plural subjects, we have used the past tense of the verb. That means we have used the second form of the verb. In negative sentences, we use did not plus root form of the verb, that means first form of the verb for all the subjects. For example, he did not work honestly. They did not take milk for breakfast. Or I did not buy this book last month. So we have used did not plus root form of the verb here. Now in interrogative sentences, we put did before the subject and use the root form of the verb. For example, did he work honestly? Or did they take milk for breakfast? Or did I buy this book last month? So we have used did before the subject here. Well, students, I hope that these rules of simple past tense or past indefinite tense are clear to you now. So let's go for some practice of this tense. Here on the screen, you have been given a few blanks and you have to fill in the blanks with the past tense of the verbs given in the brackets. You have done this kind of exercise previously also. So I hope it would be easier for you to do this exercise now. Read these sentences carefully. I dash the news in the morning, and the word is here. We dash to Mumbai by car, and the word here is travel. The child dash the correct answer, and the word in the bracket is no. Number 4 is Aman dash to eat ice cream, and the word is want. Number 5 dash Kiran dash to you, and the word is talk. Number 6 she dash food for me, and the words are not cook. And the last on the screen is Ranjan dash for a picnic with his friends, and the word on the screen is go. So read these sentences now and try to fill in the blanks with the correct answer, that is the past tense of the verbs. So take your time for doing this activity. Well, students, I hope you are ready with your answers. So let's start discussing. The first blank on the screen was I dash the news in the morning, and the word was here. And you had to use the past tense of the verb. That means the second form of the verb given in the bracket. So the first verb here was here, and the answer is heard. The past tense of here is heard. I heard the news in the morning. Number 2, we dashed to Mumbai by car, and the past tense of travel is traveled. We traveled to Mumbai by car. The child dash the correct answer, and the word in the bracket was no. Students, the past tense of the verb know is knew, so the answer is the child knew the correct answer. Number four is Aman dashed to eat ice cream, and the past tense of want is wanted. So Aman wanted to eat ice cream. Number five was an interrogative sentence, and the answer is did Kiran talk to you? Students, I hope you remember that in interrogative and negative sentences, we use did plus root form of the verb. So we have used did plus root form of the verb talk here in this blank. Number six is she dashed food for me. Again, a negative sentence here. So she did not cook food for me. Did not plus root form of the verb. And the last sentence on the screen is Ranjan dashed for a picnic with his friends, and root form of the verb go is went. So Ranjan went for a picnic with his friends. So I hope simple past tense or past indefinite tense is also clear to you now. Well, students, let's have a quick recapitulation of both the tenses that we have learnt today, and they are simple present tense, or you can say present indefinite tense, and simple past tense or past indefinite tense. Students, we use the present form for actions that happen in the present, and the past form is used for actions that happened in the past. So when we say present indefinite tense, that means we use the base form of the or the root form of the verb. And in past indefinite tense or simple past tense, we use the second form or past form of the root word. So I hope these two tenses are clear to you now. Well, students, it's time to wind up today's lecture. I hope the tenses that you have learned today will help you in improving the communication skills, verbal as well as written. We'll continue with the next aspects of the tenses in the next lecture. Till then, revise what you have learned today. Thank you for paying attention.